So good afternoon. Thanks for being here and thanks for to the Business Science Institute for giving us the opportunity to present our research outcomes. Basically, what we talk about today is about the results of a research project called SMASHING, an acronym for Social Media and Innovation. And it's the result of a joint research project gathering people from the Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology, like me, Pierre-Jean Barlatier, Emmanuel Josserand from the University of Technology of Sydney, Australia, and Angela von Beck-Baketa from the University of Geneva. Okay, so what were the objectives of the project? We have seen, and you are probably experienced it, that social media as Web 2.0 tools used to communicate by people, by companies, both within and outside the boundary, they have revolutionized the way we communicate and we exchange each other, developing and exchanging on user-generating content, which represent rich data, knowledge, and access also to information that were not so present and before. And this fostered by the new technologies offered by the internet. Okay, so on the basis on this potential learning communication, there's also a real opportunity, a huge opportunities of exploiting these tools for innovation endeavors. For this, you can source ideas for improving existing products or services as a company to develop new ones by leveraging what we call the wisdom of crowd. However, in practice, we see that there's a widening gap between companies that succeed in doing that. We have seen some success stories, such as Procter & Gamble, Starbucks, etc., that have launched their own platforms for ID crowdsourcing. But studies show that in the huge majority of firms face difficulties and problems to exploit this potential for innovation. Social media is often seen as a source of distraction regarding the product development teams. It can even be harmful to the development of innovation. Okay, so regarding that, our purpose is to find out how to best benefit from this shift of communication behavior that can be never completely restricted or controlled. So our research question were the following: what's the role of social media regarding corporate innovation dynamics? And what are the challenges and opportunities of using social media applications in relation to the innovation processes of companies? Okay, so to answer to these questions, we have created a consortium, a project, gathering complementary knowledge and expertise from three different teams. One from the Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology that I have led regarding open innovation in particular. One team based in Geneva, the team led by the Professor Badillo, the Media Lab, specialized in information communication and sociology. And finally, but not lastly, with the team led by the Professor Josserand, from the University of Technology Sydney, the Center for Business and Social Innovation, specialized in studying innovation within networks. And this project was supported by the Swiss National Science Foundation and the Luxembourg National Research Fund for a duration of 3 years. So how did we manage to study that? First, we can basically say that we have proceeded in three different phases. Okay, first, we have surveyed the literature and find out what were the current, I would say, knowledge regarding the use of social media for innovation. And we have also conducted some exploratory interviews to regarding specialists in innovation management, okay, in order to gather this kind of common knowledge about how to use social media for innovation and to basically to raise and to generate the different gaps that we need to tackle to answer the question. And then we have the pilot case studies regarding the Alpha Company. It's a pseudonym, okay? And this, I will present the outcomes of this work just after the slide. Afterwards, we have done, on the basis of these outcomes, we have done the general survey, okay, that we have addressed in numerous innovation managers in the different countries, questioning them about their practices and how do they succeed in using social media for innovation or not. And as spillovers of the outcome of this general survey, we have three other different cases that, so the survey will be presented by Emmanuel just after the pilot case studies, and Angela afterwards will develop three, what we can call these spillovers, outcomes generated by the results of the survey, regarding a specific survey regarding the Swiss SMEs, and how do they manage to use social media for open innovation, about the digital gender divide and digital identity. Okay. So let's go with the results of the pilot case studies, Alpha Company. The Alpha Company, it's a pseudonym, is a multinational company located in 70 countries in the energy and environment sectors, with something like, it's the data from 2013, but it's quite stable. So something like 150,000 employees, something like 80 billion turnover euros of turnover, and very small part for R&D, but this is the problem. So what happened to this company is that in the beginning of the 2010s, they face a major environmental shift. First, it comes from the New Deal, what in energetic transition from a centralized model to a decentralized model. Nowadays, everybody is able to produce its own energy, okay, which was not the case before. And it changes a lot the rules within the industry. They have also faced troubles with geopolitics regarding, mainly the conflict that there was and there still is, unfortunately, between Russia and Ukraine. Russia was one of the major providers within gas. And with this conflict, then it raises issues for them to regarding the supply chain in energy and how to provide gas to their customers. So regarding that, and the conjunction of all these variables led them to find ways to accelerate energy and to find new ways to generate value. So for that, they have thought about a new approach of innovation. Basically, so far they were very what we call techno-driven. Okay, this innovation comes from the new technologies that they develop. For instance, the new nuclear generation of nuclear power plants, which is not really a success. That's also one problem. And to a new approach, which is, we call that business-driven. So to develop that, they have created a new lean structure that is called Innovation and New Businesses. They have created it in 2013. And basically, it's about a small team of 20 people, mixing old-timers and newcomers to the company, mixing people from social sciences and engineers. So mixing really, I would say, based on diversity in different aspects. And the purpose of this team was to develop entrepreneurship, incubation with external partnerships and investment in high potential startups and ventures. They have to focus on three strategic domains. So we have defined three strategic domains regarding innovation. Regarding the first one is intelligent energy management, second one cities, territory, and mobility, basically smart cities, what we call smart cities. And the third one, habitat and energy performance. So these are the three new priorities. And what's very interesting is that to be able to do that, they rely on the double use of social media for innovation. So when I say double use, it means that we have created two social media platforms to generate leverage innovation. The first one, let's call this AlphaBuzz. It's also a pseudonym. It's a collaborative open innovation platform. With whose aim to attract external project ideas, competencies, partnerships. Basically, it's a kind of portal. When you have news about the companies, you have call for tenders, and as an engineer, as someone that has an idea that is in line with the three priorities that we have seen, you can submit your idea, you can contact them and tell us, hey, I am the possessor of this kind of patent. Maybe it could leverage its interest to you. Let's exchange with that. So basically, what they intend in doing that is to position themselves as the central actor regarding innovation within their industry. Okay. As you can see, there's a quote that illustrates that. Alpha is not well identified so far. We have a somewhat old-fashioned image in France and in Europe, so startups don't naturally think about us when we have projects. We need to change that. So the purpose was to change this mindset regarding and this reputation image of the company, very old-fashioned. The second platform that were launched in 2014, let's call that Innovate Alpha. It's an enterprise social networking platform where employees can submit ideas for development of new businesses incubated elsewhere. So for both platforms, they have a full-time community manager. So within this one, membership is only for employees. The other were from people from outside the company. For this one, it's only employees. So only employees are able to participate and to log in this platform. So basically, it's an ID crowdsourcing platform. So as an employee, you can submit IDs regarding a contest or things that you have experienced and you think that could be interesting to develop. And as an ID provider, you post your ID, you submit your ID. What happens next? You have the community manager that gets the ID. He makes sure that this ID is complete and understandable, and he gets this ID to one of the three experts regarding the three different domains. Okay, the ID needs to target one of the three different domains, and the expert tells, okay, this could be interesting for this business unit or not, or the others. Of he basically channeled and guide the purpose on the front of the ID. Okay, so, and as an ID bringer, you are rewarded for that on gamification principles. Basically, you post an ID, you get some points. If the ID is selected for development, you have even more points. Okay, you can be part of the development team or not, it depends. And for that, so you get some points that you can convert in an online shop, or you can give them to a charity, it depends, it's up to you. So, and it was a success. It was a success, as you can see in the numbers. They started in 2015 with 8,500 members, and it's exponentially leveraged ideas, process. Basically, the outcomes were beyond their expectations. So it's really a success to them. And so the purpose was to develop an open innovation model in which internal ideas are exposed to external input and support, because the ideas, if they are selected by a business unit for development, they are developed elsewhere. They have established partnerships with five different incubators, external incubators. And then afterwards, when the development is finished, the idea is brought back in the business unit that has participated and put some money in the development. Okay. Okay. So what we can say is that regarding these two platforms, basically the purpose was to generate new internal and external ideas to get them to maturity via external incubation in order to generate new businesses. So it was a success, but it was not so easy. So regarding this study, we have identified a set of key success factors that make this possible. The first one is that they were able to control cost and disruption of open innovation. They were able to combine this classical technologic push model of innovation, regarding their labs and the engineers that they have, with this new ecosystem pool vision of innovation. And what makes this a success is that they were able to combine the two logics between technology-based innovation and business-based innovation. Basically, what we want to get with this second model is to generate some quick wins. Things, new uses, applications, things that we haven't thought about, that were, I would say, raised by employees, by external stakeholders, people from the ecosystem. The second key success factors is about the importance of integration. Okay. What makes this possible and what makes this a success is that they have since the beginning a clear vision of strategy and roles regarding the use of social media for innovation. They have the whole process. They know what kind of stakeholders we wanted to reach via the use of the different, I would say, platforms. And what's also important is the integration of the outcomes of the ID sponsoring, I would say, initiatives, is that directly, BU were addressed the purpose of the ID. Are you interested in developing this or not? If you are, then you directly, since the beginning, you participate in the development. It's not something that is developed and then we forgot it. No, you participate in development, you fund this 50%, and then it's also a way to make sure that at the end, the business unit, as it is part of its activity, will try to get back the outcomes of the ideas and to get back the outcome of the development process. What goes from out from the external incubation. Third success factors is that they were able to leverage complementarities. Okay, they proposed two new social media tools. Social media, you know, there are many tools. You have public social media, Facebook, Twitter, etc. You have a lot of social media tools. Now it's really boring for employees, for people, okay, because you have the habit to use some specific ones, okay. And see if it's the purpose is to add one over the pool of the software that we have, then it will not be used. So what they have done, they have studied the use of social media for innovation in every business unit. And they try to propose something that is complementary to the classical use. In business unit, basically, they use social media to track knowledge, to solve problems. Basically, I would say for purpose of exploitation, to better exploit, to better leverage knowledge for what they are doing to solve problems that we have from day-to-day practices. And in the logic of developing, for instance, Innovate Alpha, they try to leverage social media to develop exploration, something that is really new, something I didn't think about. Okay? So then it's really complementary to what were existing within the BUs, and then it's more easy to convince people to use that by showing them that it's different, it's for a different purpose. And the last one, is they work a lot, but really a lot, on bottom-up adoption. Regarding ergonomics and usability, they put a lot of effort in that, because when you ask people to use social media platforms, now you need at least to develop functionalities such as the one that you will find on Facebook. Okay? Because people expect this kind of quality. If you don't have that, then it will not be used. So you really have to put effort and investment in ergonomics and usability of the platform to test some functionalities, so to propose and to people, employees, to test some new functionalities. Do you really need that? Do you find this interesting or not? And then, if not, you drop that. But if it's interesting, then you add functionalities that people are interested in. And another thing that is really important is about the promotion of the tool. The people that I have mentioned within the new unit, the 20 people, they worked a lot and they were present in the whole, I would say, business day, innovation day within the company to say, hey, there's a new platform, try to use that, this is how you have to use that, etc. They work like evangelists. Okay, this is something that you have to use, etc., because it's a corporate tool. Okay, and they put a lot of effort in that, and they really need to do that, because if not, it's people who wouldn't think about that, or etc. Basically, you have the competition is the other tools, and you have to show, to demonstrate what's the, really the added value of using them. Okay, and thanks to these results, to this new insight that we have generated via our literature survey and the result of this case, we were able to, to elaborate an interesting survey regarding, I would say, a general use of social media by companies. And Emmanuel will present you the outcomes.